of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, I pray, oh God, that your presence, oh God, may your word, Father, from your kingdom, oh Lord, come and speak to your church, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm going to be very short, amen.
Amen.
The commission, as we are the body of Christ, amen. The commission that the Lord has given me is to prepare the church about his second coming. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm going to read the book of Revelation 13. Amen. Amen. Verse 9, only one verse. It says, okay, pardon. Pardon me, it's Revelation 13, verse 7. It reads as follows. And the beast was allowed to wage war against God's holy people and to conquer them. And he was given authority to rule over every tribe and people and language and nation. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible tells us that in the end times, amen, the beast was given the power. The Hebrew word for God's children, it says kadoshim. Amen. Was given the power to overcome kadoshim, the God's people. Amen. Now there is something that the Lord showed me. Amen. I know we are not yet, and we are in the end, we are at the bad pains. Amen. There is something that the Lord has shown me. Amen. He showed me a vision. The first vision, amen, he showed me cows. Amen. And he showed me an antelope. Amen. And that antelope had a horn. Amen. And then the antelope tried to attack the cows. The first time the cows outnumbered the antelope, and then the antelope ran. Amen. And then the second vision, amen, I saw many cows. Amen. And then from different directions came many antelope with horns. Amen. And then the number of cows started to decrease. Amen. And then the Spirit of the Lord told me that this means the antelopes with horns. Amen. The antelope, the horns represent the rulership. Amen. The rulership of the world. And as we read in the Bible, the cow, the bull represent the power. Amen. The power of the Christians. Amen. First time, the enemy is going to wage war because the enemy looks for a body. Amen. The enemy does not come in the world with the spirit. He has to obey the principle given by God. Amen. He also knows the spiritual principles. Amen. And just like Jesus Christ had to come in the flesh. Amen. And obey the principle of sacrifice. Amen. The enemy also will come as a beast, the man, and take a form of a human being to wage war against the church. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now, there is nothing that the enemy can do, amen, without using the body, without using, following the principles, amen. And when I was in this place, when we were praying, amen, there's few things that the Lord has also revealed to me, amen. The Lord showed me a cup, amen. And then at the cup, a hand lifted that cup up, amen. And the Lord was just filling the cup, amen. So in this service, the Lord has given us strength, amen. The Lord has given us oil, amen, to go out in these last days, amen, to go out in these end times, amen. Because I remember one night, the Lord had wakened me, amen, and he told me that I am coming, amen. It's not, I know most of the people, most of us take this as a joke, that we have been saying that Christ is coming. But in the book of Esdras, amen, the Bible says, Esdras asked the angel Uriel that when is the time, amen. Angel Uriel says that the time that passed is longer than the time that is left. Amen. Amen. The Bible says, let those who have the, an ear to hear, listen to what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. Amen. Amen. If you know and obey the principles of God, of the spiritual reality, because one thing about the church, the enemy and the demons know. Amen. They know and understand these principles. Amen. But if the church can stand up in these end times, because there's going to be an activation, there's going to be a revival. Amen. The Lord is going to send a revival. Amen. And then this revival is going to start in the church. Amen. As it starts in the church, it will flow out to the world. Amen. And only those who are ready and prepared and understand the spiritual principles will receive this grace. Revival. Amen. Amen. The Lord has laid out everything. Amen. There is nothing, because we have knowledge. We have knowledge. The Bible says my children suffers because of lack of knowledge. Amen. And then we have knowledge, but knowledge takes grace to manifest. Amen. Because you can have knowledge but lack the manifestation. You can be full of words. You can be full of knowledge. Paul says, the kingdom of God is not a matter of words, but it's a matter of power. Amen. You can be full of knowledge, but lack manifestation. Amen. Manifestation is activated by grace. Amen. And grace, in order to enter the dimension of grace, you have to enter the dimension of dying to flesh. Amen. And in order to die to the flesh, you have to obey the spiritual principles of God. Amen. God has laid out principles, and this is his call unto the church. I want to tell you, do not be relaxed. Amen. Do not be relaxed. Sit no longer. Amen. Wait no longer. Amen. Start going to your closets. Amen. Start obeying the voice of God. Amen. Start seeking the face of God. Amen. Because he is saying that he is coming. Amen. And he's coming for his church. He's coming for his bride. Amen. The Lord looks for a heart. Amen. One thing that is important to the Lord is the heart. Amen. Amen. The heart is so important to the Lord. If your heart is not clean, therefore, you cannot experience the move of God. Amen. Amen. Because God said that he said that I will take out the heart of flesh, of stone, and put in a heart of flesh. Amen. Because as normal human beings, we are born in sin. We are born in the flesh. Amen. And the flesh naturally, amen, has a heart of stone. Amen. Now if we allow God to put in a heart of flesh,